biggest problems that guitar players will tend to have when they're trying to create melody is that of closely tying in what they're playing so that it matches up to the chords that are going on underneath. So in this discussion, I'm going to offer up a reality check here to that, because if you pay close attention to simply using the chord shapes that are possible to have, you know, in the song that you're playing over, and if you focus in on them, if you just start to realize how a few unique chord shapes can actually open up a whole other region to yourself on the guitar neck, you're going to be able to jam your solos off of those regions and have a lot of fun doing so. You can also discover that you can closely track the chord harmony with rather minimal effort when you learn how to do this very well. It might sound kind of complicated, but you know what? In this video, I'm going to walk you through this method with a collection of examples so that after we're done, you're going to be able to start producing some of these ideas yourself on guitar. Everything starts from the chord progression found within the song that you're going to be playing your solo over, and those chords are critical to understand. You want to understand them fully and completely. And in order to get things started with you, we're going to need some context here, so I want to introduce a chord progression. It's going to be fairly basic, just a straightforward key of A major chord progression. We're going to use this group of chords to just focus in on the principles that we're going to study, and we're going to build some melodies within it, stuff like that. So first of all, I want to play this chord progression down for you. I'm just going to use the most basic open position chords. I will have one bar chord in here, but you always need more bar chord trading. That's an important element to work with. So I'm going to play this thing down for you. I'd like you to learn it as well, and then we're going to move on from there. Is to start mapping out some unique chord patterns. I guess you already know that chord patterns are obviously the way that we perform the rhythm guitar parts of our songs, but chord patterns can also be an excellent way to trace out a melody line that'll function nicely within a piece that you want to play a lead part over. So what we're going to do next is analyze a new and a more unique group of smaller chord patterns that correspond to the progression's harmony. So it'll still be all the same chords, you know, of the A major, E major, F sharp minor and the D major chord. We're still in the key of A major and all that, but these chords are going to be used to perform the rhythm part as I'll play them right now. However, we're going to take things a little bit further with them, because we're going to also use these chord patterns as a way to make melody lines around the chord harmony of our progression. So before we go any further, I want to play the example of progression again, but this time I'm going to use some more unique chord patterns on the guitar neck. Okay, so the third thing that we're going to look at doing now is that we've established our progression, we've analyzed it, we know what key we're in, we've made some unique chords for it. Next thing up is we are going to map a melody. Now, the objective of this whole chord licks approach is to work toward tracing out the guitar's chord changes that we have for what we're using for the melody lines. It's going to be formed around one or two scale patterns only, and it's going to be looking at the notes found closest to those templates of our unique chord patterns. Not the basic chord patterns, but we're going to be looking at those smaller three-note unique patterns. So those chord patterns are going to be like our sweet spot notes or our golden notes for us. And even if your scale knowledge is kind of limited, you can still rely mostly upon the chord patterns themselves to produce some excellent sounding melody lines. It is going to kind of sound a little bit more like arpeggios if you really tie it into that exclusively. It's better to use the chords as templates and go around the scale tones as sort of the bulk of your ideas. But let me demonstrate as to how this can work based upon using those smaller unique chord patterns that we just learned for our example progression. I have a short melody line here that I've composed. I'm going to play it for you right now. Thank you. we've done so far goes a pretty long way to help with producing an initial map for playing licks around chords on guitar. All it really takes is studying how to branch out from a few unique chord shapes, and that'll help you, you know, lead over to having a greater understanding of playing better melody. And what's really cool is that this chord licks idea will also push a guitarist further along to help with gaining a much better understanding of how to use the full scale patterns on guitar. You know, scale patterns that I just used here for this application are rather simple. Around the harmony that we just worked in here in A major, I really only was including two fingerboard example shapes of the basic A major scale. And maybe what I should do is zoom in on the neck and just play you those two shapes right now. Those are the only two scales that I was really focusing on when I laid out those unique chord voicings and then played around them. And, you know, I think if you put some effort into this and by using this type of approach, your soloing is going to improve. You're going to map things out a little bit more towards small chord shapes and really have a lot more sweet spot notes, you know, really good quality notes to hit. And your understanding of scales is going to get better because you're going to start mapping them into essentially arpeggios. You know, those chord tones are all arpeggios. You'll start finding it easier to play licks and lines and runs, you know, wherever you're going to need them on the neck. If some of this stuff is weak for you, though, you may need to lay down some preliminary work and get a little bit better at your chords on the guitar neck as well as your scales and noticing how they correspond. And a lot of the course information that I have over on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com can help you, you know, in a lot of different ways with that information. So anyway, this is the system. I hope you have some success with it, and I hope you find it fun to create solos with. Well, I'd like to end the discussion by saying thanks for joining me. If you want to learn more about what I do as an online guitar teacher, then head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for your free lifetime membership. When you want more, you can always upgrade to either a basic or a premium lesson package and start studying all the guitar courses I've organized for the members of my website. Also, I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on all this in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again, and we'll catch up next time for another episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. Hi everybody, Andrew Wasson here from creativeguitarstudio.com. I've been a professional guitarist for over 25 years now, and I've been teaching guitar for even longer than that. But today I want to talk to you about your current situation by discussing the study of guitar and the time that you have available to put into it. If you're like most people, you're working a 9-to-5 job and you're working 8 hours a day, 40 hours a week, that's 160 hours a month. How much free time does that leave you left over to study guitar? Let's say you can maybe fit in an hour or so, around 4 or 5 days in a week when you have the free time. And if that is the case, wouldn't you want to make the most of that 1 hour of study, practicing a highly organized, step-by-step, well-structured guitar curriculum? Without a structured plan, it's pretty easy to waste time. You know, a lot of times it happens by just focusing on playing through a bunch of stuff you know, songs you know, riffs you already know, licks that you're familiar with. But practicing stuff you already know will not make you a better guitar player. You need a constant supply of fresh material. You know, if you practice guitar by just playing stuff you already know, before you realize it, time ticks on, time ticks by, and that valuable period of time that you have every day, it gets lost. If left alone, those hours lost every day turn into lost weeks, lost months, and then eventually lost years of wasted time. You'll still be the same guitar player that you were before because you never challenged yourself. I've seen it dozens and dozens of times in my own studio here. But you know, you can change that. In the valuable time that you do have every day, you can start studying a comprehensive guitar course that'll not only educate you, but it'll turn you into a well-skilled musician. So if you want to learn more, sign up for a free account through my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. The general access membership is absolutely free to join. Come in, get your feet wet, and when you're ready, you can go for the paid membership. What you'll discover in there is the most comprehensive guitar curriculum available online. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.